Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to create a custom theme in Excel. A custom theme is useful when you need to create documents or presentations with a specific look. For example, if your employer or client has branding elements you need to use. Plus, once you create your theme, it will also be available in other applications of your Office suite, such as Microsoft Word and PowerPoint. The themes options are in the Page Layout tab in the Themes section. There are already several preset themes to choose from, but in this example, we'll create our own. We'll do this in three parts. We'll first create a custom color palette, then choose a font, and lastly, we'll choose effects for any objects we may use. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. To create a color palette, select colors from the Themes section. This contains several color palettes already. Likely, your computer is defaulting to the one labeled Office. As I scroll down the list of color palettes, you see the color of my examples changing. You could select one of these, but for this example, let's select Customize Colors so that we can set our own. All the items that we can change the color for are listed here for us. We simply have to decide what color we'd like for those items. And then here, the sample has two basic layout options. So we have a dark text on a light background and a light text with a dark background. As we change the color, we'll see this change here in our samples. For example, the dark text on the light background, we can decide on a deep violet, and you see this text change as you do that. We can change the light text on the dark background to say a light green, and we see the accents change as well. You can change the actual background color. The accent colors are represented here in the bar chart samples. So we can change this blue to say a sunny yellow, and we can keep changing these to whatever we'd like to see. To do a custom color, which you may need to for your specific brand, simply select More Colors, and in the Custom tab, you can enter the RGB number for the color of your choice. Once you've completed all your color updates, simply give your color palette a name and select Save. And when we do that, we see that our sample items here have all changed color as well. And we've also learned that I am not a designer, but this is a good segue into how we can edit our custom color palette. So we'll come back to Colors, select our new palette, right-click, and choose Edit. And here we can change any of the elements. So we'll change our fun sunny yellow to maybe a more toned-down orange, and then we'll change our text and light background to something even lighter. So we'll choose a little bit of a lighter green. Click Save, and that still doesn't look great, but it's easier on the eye, so we can continue with this example. To customize font combinations, select Fonts. And these combinations represent what will be the heading font and the font used for the body in your documents. So the top font is the heading, and the bottom font represents what will be used in the body. So many of these use the same font for both, but as you scroll, you do see some that use a different font for the heading and the body. Now, if you'd like to create your own combination, select Customize Fonts. And from here, you'll have a dropdown with all of the fonts installed in your system. So if you've already installed your brand fonts, this is where you would go to get those custom fonts. And once you select what you'd like, and we'll just change this a little bit just for variety, like with the color palette, you would give it a name, select Save, and you would see your new font combination listed here in the fonts dropdown. Select Effects to, well, customize the effects for our theme. These affect design elements like our smart art example. Notice how it's changing as I scroll over the different options. And while you're currently not able to customize an effect, you do have several to choose from. You would just select the one that best fits your needs. And once you've set your color palette, font, and effects choices, simply come back to Themes and select Save Current Theme to save your theme. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful to learn how to create a custom brand theme in Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.